Hello and welcome to a new video here on my channel here at commaik. Have you ever wondered why your Reolink cameras, NVRs, home hubs and so on are not running the latest software even though you have activated automatic updates? Well, there is a way to manually check for updates and install them. If you want to know how this works, then stay tuned because that's exactly what I'll show you in this video. As you know, I use a variety of Reolink cameras. I have the home hub, I have my network video recorder, the doorbell and many other devices. Reolink offers regular updates. The company is updated and new features are made available. However, I have now noticed that not all cameras automatically get these updates, even though I have activated automatic updates. Well, with battery cameras there is no longer any way to manually check what the current firmware is, what new features there are, because this is controlled centrally by Reolink, but for wired cameras, for the Pro variants, even for the WLAN variants with a power connection, there is the option to manually check the updates and also manually transfer them to the cameras. Here on the small one that you can already see behind me on the PC, I will show you how to find out which firmware is actually running on the camera. I will show you where you can look up which is the most recent firmware, and of course I will also show you how to upload the most recent firmware to your camera. I am in the client overview and have selected my TrackMix camera as an example. I can access the settings via the gear wheel, and under info I can see the current data about the camera, including the firmware currently in use. I switched to system maintenance and here I have the option of starting the firmware update manually or automatically. The auto update is active. This means that the camera should basically update itself automatically. However, I can click on the latest version to check whether there is a newer version. You can see that there is no new version available. I set up the Home Assistant to use a few smart functions at home. Among other things, I noticed that the settings show me updates from connected devices. Among other things, you can see the TrackMix camera here, which is suggested for an update. If I click on the whole thing, I see the current version that I have and a newer version that I could use. The Home Assistant offers me to update the camera directly using the update button. I won't do that at this point, because I want to show you how you can do the whole thing manually. To search for the firmware manually, I went to the Reolink Download Center website. You can find the link to the download sender under the video in the description. Here I first select my model by simply entering the name. The possible suitable cameras are already suggested to me and I select my Pro camera. Next, I have to select the hardware number. There is only one to choose from here. If you want to know which hardware number you have, look in the info center of the camera's settings menu. I click on search and the system offers me several updates. My Reolink TrackMix camera is currently using the lower firmware of the two versions offered here. I have the 3748. However, there is currently a newer version, namely 425 from December 15, 2024. Under notes and news I can now read what has changed. The network services have been optimized and minor errors have been fixed. Nothing serious. So, I click download firmware, get another note that I should be aware of what I am doing here and, above all, that I should check again that the selected cameras are actually the right ones. I agree and the software is downloaded to my computer in the background. I can now see the downloaded file in my download folder as a zip format. I can see that it is a firmware for the Reolink TrackMix PoE version 425. I unpack the zip file by right-clicking on More Options here. In addition to the file with the firmware, a Reolink PDF is also displayed or unpacked, which explains again how to carry out the update. The POC is the decisive factor, however. Back in the client, I am still in the maintenance menu. I can select the file directly via browse. I start the upload with a double click. After a while, the file is displayed and I can choose whether I want to reset the camera when installing the update. Of course, I don't do that because I want to keep all the settings. I click on upgrade straight away. Only now does the camera show me a message that there is a newer firmware. The upgrade process can take a few minutes. At the end, there is a success message and the camera restarts. So you can see that the entire update process only takes a few minutes and is not complicated at all. If your camera's NVR, home hub or doorbell are missing some functions or are not working as they should, then just check to see if there is a firmware update that you can install manually. You can find the link to the download channel under the video. There you will also find the like button. I would be really pleased if you clicked it, because that helps me and my channel move forward. If you want to see more from me, click the subscribe button and you won't miss any of the new videos. And if you want to know what all these packages are all about, which cameras I use, what I have tested, what I can recommend and what I can't, then take a look under the video. There you will find my playlists and of course the relevant product links to the cameras that I use myself and that I am happy with. Thank you very much for watching. Until the next video, take care. Ciao.